CPM or critical path method, how CPM increases work in progress. If you are ready to hear, like one of the biggest sins are, is however you say that, in construction, something you cannot do and how CPM is specifically designed to do that, if you want to know all about that truth and how you should stay away from it and what you should do instead, then this is the video for you. This is a 5-minute video, but I'm going to give you this hard truth and link you to a longer video about CPM that you can check out if you want. So let's dive right into it. If you're dealing with the critical path method in construction, you're dealing with a time on the top by deliverable format with activities that are logic tied together in a sequence where the computer using the logic will do what's called a forward and a backward pass, and using the algorithm will identify a critical path. And that critical path is the path where if any activity is delayed, it delays the entire project. And that is absolutely insane, because when you do the forward and the backward pass, it's basically taking what could have otherwise been leveled work and it's increasing that work in an attempt to finish sooner. But the problem is anything above the capacity of resources is what's really going to hurt us. So let me talk about WIP, or work in progress. You're probably used to this term when you're looking at financial documents and projecting your financial outlook for your construction company, your WIP report, but I'm not talking about it in that same vein. What I'm talking about WIP is work in process, okay? Work in process is mainly manufacturing, but when I'm talking about it, I'm talking about work in progress, and that's on a construction project. Okay, so that's for construction. And here's the key concept. If you see it in a graph, and this is the WIP, this kind right here, and you look at it with the x-axis being time, the amount of work in progress that you can have on your construction project has a certain capacity. And this line is basically representing what your trade partners can do. And CPM is genius, in a bad way, at increasing work in progress. And I've shown you this a little bit, but I'm going to dig deeper. Basically, when you do that forward and backward pass without constraining start dates, and everything is an early start, and you have the owner and the contractor like breathing down your neck, and you've identified a critical path and you have zero float, not only is this already gone, it's a non-starter, it's a non-reality, because you will come up with problems throughout. Not only is this a worthless measurement, not only is it stupid to not have buffers, but what it does is it says, hey, you know, owner, contractor, you should tell your trades to do more work than they're able to do. And people think mistakenly, oh, that's going to get us finished sooner. That's not what's going to happen. What's going to happen is you're going to enter into a downward productivity spiral and your project is going to finish late. So you do not have the option of finishing sooner. You can finish on a flow, or you can finish late because you're pushing. You only have option one, option two. And I think option two is stupid. Okay, so let me explain to you what happens here. When you run your computer program, which is absolutely ridiculous, I really don't think the creators of CPM ever thought about this even a little bit. It increases work in progress 100%. But if you take a slice out of the production plan, you will see a couple of things happening. If you have work that's supposed to happen in a certain area, you'll see too many trades in one area, which is called trade stacking. Or if you take one trade and do an analysis in that slice, you'll see that that trade is supposed to be in 9 different areas when they can only do that one area. This right here is called trade burdening. And what that does is it enters you into a downward productivity spiral where the productivity of your crew plummets, and everything, like I said, takes longer over here at the end. So in summary, which I typically don't do, but I'm gonna do it right now. Because of the algorithm, it increases WIP. Because you have a critical path without buffers, it increases WIP. Because everything's set to an early start, it increases WIP. Because it's in a myopic format with large batch areas that aren't properly zoned, it's pushing and stacking people, and so it increases WIP. It is designed to do this in the effort to rush and push and panic. And the other thing is it always ends up with trade stacking and trade burdening and hurting people. And the worst part about it is even if you didn't care about people, you enter into a productivity downward spiral. And it's really bad, and you're never going to recover from it. And this is the reason that every single construction project in our industry using CPM has problems, and why we're on the decline from a productivity standpoint. CPM increases work in progress above the capacity of resources. I'm gonna put this into a visual and a little blog post, but also link you to a longer video so you can check it out. This is super crucial. Please help me to share the message. On we go.